Assalamu alaikum students, welcome to the new lecture of engineering drawing and graphics, and this is your lecture number 11. And as you already know, we are studying geometric dimensioning and tolerancing, that is the GD and T. So we know that this is an SME 14.5 dimensioning and tolerancing standard, and we have already discussed all these type of tolerances, that was the form tolerance, profile tolerance, orientation, runout, and the location type of GD and T tolerances. So today we are going to see some of them with examples, that how we measure them and how they are important for our part design and part profile. So let's do that. So here we have our first geometric dimensioning and tolerancing control, and that control is the control of a straightness of a line element. As you know, we discussed that we have basic geometric elements, and then one of them was the point, the other one was the line, then we have a plane, and then we have a solid. So basically, what a line is, it is a basic geometric element, and that line can be seen on different type of geometries. For example, we can check the straightness on a cylinder, and we can also check the straightness of a rectangular plate. So how much straight we want them to be, this option is given to us by this straightness GD and T. And as you see, we have the first, in the first box we have the GD and T symbol, and then in the second we have the tolerance. So now the straightness tolerance on this cylinder is 0.002, and similarly the straightness tolerance on this flat plate, as you can see, this rectangular slab, is 0.002 also. So the size, as you can see, this is the MMC and the LMC of this part, and this also is the MMC and the LMC of that part. So as you can see, the general tolerances are already specified, but we for a specific geometric feature, that is the straightness, we have added the straightness GD and T to give us more control over the design of this part. So now what we do, we build a tolerance zone. We already know that 0.002 is our straightness tolerance. So what we do, we draw two lines that are 0.002 apart, depends, this is, let's say, inch. So it is 0.002 inches apart, and the tolerance zone size is this much, that is 0.002 tolerance zone. So within this tolerance zone, the line element should lie within this tolerance zone for this part to be correct. So this is what our straightness of line elements is about. And to see this a bit more clearly, here is another example where you can see the two views of this cylinder, and here it is, this is the actual line element of this cylinder. So for this cylinder to be straight, the actual line element should lie between this tolerance zone. So we will say that the straightness on this cylinder is as it is required. So now we have another example, and this is about the circularity. So circularity is for cylindrical parts, and it is checked on a single line. If we take a single point on this cylinder, and then we rotate this part, we rotate this part along its axis, so we will be getting the circularity on a single line on this cylinder. So circularity is specifically for circular features. So as you can see right here in the foremost box, here is the circle, that is the symbol for the circularity in the feature control frame, and in the second box we have the tolerance, and you can also see that the general tolerances are also specified. So here also we will have a tolerance zone, and that tolerance will, zone should be 0.002 inches, and within this tolerance zone the actual profile, the actual circular profile of this cylinder should lie. So we will say that the circularity on this cylinder right here is perfect. And here we can see the inspection method, that the cylinder is placed on a spindle and this spindle rotates, and then we place our dial gauge on one point on this cylinder and it tells us about the circularity. So here this dial gauge should be, the deflection of this dial gauge should be within 0.002 of an inch. That deflection should not be more than this value. If it is more than this value, then it means that the circularity's tolerances is not achieved. Here we can see from another example that how these two views of a cylinder, but the actual profile of this cylinder, that is the circle, should lie between these two circles, that is our two concentric circles that are 0.002, 0.03 inches apart, that is the tolerance zone. So this is our circularity GD&T. Then we have flatness, and flatness is for rectangular parts, or you can say prismatic parts. And here we have a plate right here with a hole, and as you can see, this is the, if you can say, this is the front view and this is the side view right here of this plate. And as you can see, we have a flatness tolerance on this edge, on this edge of this plate, which is this edge right here. If we look at the side, this edge right here, and the flatness tolerance is 0.002 inches. And for our flatness to be within 0.002, we will draw this tolerance zone, that is two planes apart, and our line element should lie within this tolerance zone. And this is the method to measure the flatness of a plate. As you can see, it's placed on a slab that is perfectly placed, and we put our part on this flat rectangular plate, and with a leveling feet we completely level it with this plate, and then we place our dial gauge and we move our dial gauge on this flat plate, and the reading on this dial gauge should not exceed 0.002 of an inch. So this is how we measure the flatness of a part. And here is another example that you can see that the actual line profile on this rectangular slab right here, but that line profile should lie between these two parallel planes. So this is what flatness is all about, and this is how we check it. And as you can see in the feature control frame, we have the flatness symbol and then the tolerance that is required for this geometric feature. Then we have cylindricity, and cylindricity is for the whole cylinder. As you remembered, on in circularity was checked at one point on a cylinder, but cylindricity is checked on the whole cylinder, on the whole surface on the cylinder. We move the dial gauge in a spiral manner like this, and then we check the cylindricity of a part. So as you can see, this is the symbol for cylindricity and the tolerance that is specified. And as you can see, we will have an envelope, a cylindrical envelope in this case, which is two concentric cylinders that are 0.002 apart, and within these two concentric cylinders the part profile should lie. As you can see right here, there is another example right here, and here you can see the two lines for these two concentric cylinders perfectly circle, and the actual profile of this cylinder should lie between these two concentric cylinders. And here you can see both the top side and the downside of this cylinder. So this is how we check the cylindricity on a cylindrical part. Then we have parallelism, and parallelism, as you can see, is an orientation type of GD&T. And now what we will have, we should also have a datum that will be our reference point from which we will be measuring this GD&T. So here is the parallelism symbol, then the tolerance that is required for this GD&T, and then the in the third most feature control frame box, we have our datum A. This is this surface of this rectangular block, and here we have another example in which the parallelism of this cylindrical feature right here is checked with reference to this base of this part. So here we will have two envelopes, and within these envelopes should be 0.002 apart. So this will be our tolerance zone, but that tolerance zone will be specified with respect to this datum A. So now we also have a datum in place. As compared to the previous examples that we studied, we did not had a datum, but now we have a datum surface, that is our reference surface, and from that reference surface we will measure our parallelism for this flat plate. And as you can see, here a cylindrical part is involved, so we will take the axis of the cylindrical part, and then we will check the parallelism of this axis with this datum right here. So here we have both the measuring methods. This is for the flat plate, and the flat plate is made parallel with this edge of this flat plate, and we place it on a perfectly flat plate, and then we move the dial gauge on this on the top surface. So that dial gauge should give us the reading within 0.002 inches. And as for this part is concerned, the cylindrical feature we have in place, and that cylindrical feature's flatness is measured with the help with reference to this surface of this part. So we move the dial gauge on this cylindrical feature, and we get the deflection of this dial, and that deflection should be within 0.002 inches. To see another example, parallelism is basically the flatness of a flat surface on a part, on a rectangular part, reference to another surface. So this is difference from the flatness, but if we measure a flatness of a certain, if we measure a flatness of a certain surface with respect to a datum, so that is known as the checking the parallelism GDNT. So now we have a datum surface, because the other side of this part can also be rough. So that's why we should take the datum on which this other side of this plate is placed, so that we should also take into account the roughness of this back side of this rectangular part. So that's why we are actually checking the flatness of this edge with reference to this edge. So we take a perfectly flat plane, and we call it a datum, and we place this part on this datum, and then we check the flatness of this top surface. So this is how we check the parallelism. Then we have a profile, and if we have, let's say, an arc or another complex shape other than a complete surface, a circle or a line, then what we call it, we call it a profile. But we check a profile along a line that is moving these dial gauges along this straight, along one straight path, along this profile linearly. So this is how checking a profile GDNT works. And we have a symbol for our profile in the feature control frame, then the tolerance that should be specified, and with the datum surface. Remember that it is in profile of a line or a surface, we may require a datum or we may not require a datum. So it is optional, but depends on the design of your part. Here a datum is given, so we should mention the datum right here. So this is checking the profile of a line that is other than a circle or a complete line. Here we have an arc, so that arc should lie between these two envelopes, and these envelopes should be apart by the amount of tolerance that is mentioned. Here no tolerance is mentioned, so we mention it in terms of two axes. So here is another example in which another complex shape part which have a profile on the top surface, so that profile should lie between these tolerance due to these two parallel lines, and these lines are with respect to these two datums. These are the two datums. One is this datum right here, and the other is this datum right here. So the profile of this surface is checked along a straight linear path, and that is with respect to these two datum surfaces, that is that datum A and the datum B. So the profile of this line should be within 0.03 inches, with respect to datum A and the datum B. So this is how we check the profile of a line. Then we have a profile of a surface, and in this case what we will do, we will move the dial gauges in a zigzag manner along this profile. So we will get the profile of a surface as compared to the profile of a line that was moved linearly along a straight path. So this is the symbol that is used, and here it is also being checked with respect to the datum surface. Here is another method in which we can see that the profile of a line is checked with respect to these two datum surface. Sorry, the profile of a surface. As you can see, the whole surface is shaded as pink. So this is checking the profile of a surface between these two parallel planes, and these parallel planes are also shaped as our profile is shaped. So the parallelism of the surface is checked with respect to these two datums. But now this surface has a certain amount of profile and arc shape, so that's why we check it between these two lines that is also of the same shape, and that is also checking it with respect to these two datum surfaces, that is datum A and the datum B. So this is the profile of a surface GD&T. Then we have concentricity, and concentricity is checked when we are talking about stepper shaft. And in stepper shafts we have two diameters. One is a small cylinder that have a minor diameter, and the other is a large cylinder that has a major diameter. So what we do, we make sure that the smaller cylinder is concentric with respect to the larger cylinder, which means that they both lie on the same axis as much as they can. So here you can see that the dial gauges are oriented in a certain way, and we move the dial gauges or we move the spindle, and the dial gauges will give us the reading at different points. Here we will see that how concentric or is this smaller cylindrical feature is with respect to this larger cylindrical feature. And here, as you can see, the outer cylindrical feature is a datum for this inner smaller cylindrical feature, and we check it with the help of the dial gauges, and the tolerance that is mentioned is 0.005 with respect to this datum A, that is the outer cylindrical feature, and this is how we inspect it. Here is another example of a stepper shaft, and as you can see, the tolerance zone is around the axis of this shaft. So we make sure that this is our datum axis, that is exactly straight, and we take this tolerance zone with respect to this datum axis, and then we check our concentricity of this smaller cylindrical feature with respect to this larger cylindrical feature. Here now we have an example of positioning, and in positioning what we do, we position a certain feature with this on a part. So here we have a rectangular slab, and the feature that we mentioned right here is a hole, and we will check the position of this hole with respect to these three datum surfaces, that is this surface right here, this base right here, and the top surface right here. So we will check the position of this hole with respect to these three datum surfaces. So that's why these three datum surfaces are mentioned on the feature control frame. We have our position symbol, and we have our position tolerance, that is 0.03 diameter for this circle. So now let's elaborate that, what does this mean. Let's say we take this circle right here and we draw it here the enlarged view of this hole right here. You can see the axis of the hole and the hole itself. So now let's draw the tolerance zone, that what will be the positional tolerance zone for this circle right here. So here we have this tolerance zone, that is the 0.03 inch diameter tolerance zone that is mentioned right here. And as you can see, we also have a modifier, and that modifier is for the maximum material condition. So what does that mean? Here, as you can see, the basic diameter of this hole is mentioned, and we have our general tolerances. So if we write these two limits, we will have 10.05 inches of a hole, and that will be the LMC in case of a hole, and then we will have a 9.5 9.95, yes, 9.95 inch of a hole, and that will be the MMC for this hole. So this is the MMC for this hole. So now what does that mean? It means that if we have a 10 inch diameter hole, if we have a 10 inch diameter hole, this right here is a 10 inch diameter hole, so the LMC will be 10.05. So it will be drawn on the outside of this actual 10 inches diameter hole, and the MMC will be drawn on the inside. So what does that mean? Here the modifier is with the MMC. So now let's just draw the MMC and leave all the other values behind. So let's clear out that area. We have identified our tolerance zone, that is the smaller circle at the axis of this larger circle. That is the tolerance zone for the position of the circle. And now let's draw this hole, this 10 inch hole, as this we will draw this now as 9.95 inches. So this is how our 9.95 inches hole will look like. This is our 9.9 inch hole. So what does that mean? This hole is our MMC. This is our at maximum material condition, because this is in case for a hole, and at 9.95 inches the hole will have the maximum material. So now let's add the positional tolerance, and this will come out to be 9.98. So this will further reduce our inner circle size. And now this right here, if you draw it, this will be equal to our 9.98 inches hole. So this means, this M means that if we place a position tolerance on this hole, so this is our position tolerance. This envelope represents 0.03 inches diameter, and when we move this, let's say if we move this hole in this zone right here, so this hole will move within this envelope, this MMC envelope. This hole will be within this 9.98 inches envelope if we try to move this hole or position this hole within this 0.03 inches envelope. So this 0.03 inches envelope means that our hole will be within 9.98 inches if we place the position tolerance with the maximum material condition. So this is why this modifier is used to correctly identify our positional tolerance for our hole. So the minimum that the size can be for this hole, that should be the 9.98 inches if we identify a positional tolerance of 0.003 inches in case of this example right here. So this was an example of our positional tolerance, in which we saw the position tolerance of a hole with respect to these datum surfaces, but we also identified the position tolerance zone, and then we also explained that what this material modifier means. It means that we will then look at the MMC condition for this hole, and the MMC condition was at 9.95 inches, and here the modifier is with the maximum material condition. So we will take our position tolerance and we will add that position tolerance to this MMC right here, and we will get another diameter 9.98 inches, and that 9.98 inches will identify the position for this hole in which this hole should lie if we move this hole within this 0.03 inch position tolerance range. So, this was clear.